soft. I hope you're all well and everything is going well for your aquariums. Today I want to share with you something I have in mind, a new project I would like to begin working on at some point. Now I know it is the middle of October and therefore here in Scotland winter has begun. Although apart from that, I just want to say I picked up these two aquariums from a friend of mine who has his own fish store, and he completely re-renovated his store. New aquariums, the whole lot. I mean, his store is looking amazing. The name of the store is Waterworld Aquatics, in Glasgow, Paisley Road West. So if you're from this area, perhaps you can check it out. And I'm telling you, the quality of the fish are top. I mean, unbeatable. So, and he's very honest, and he, you know, if you're also a beginner, or if you are in the hobby and you've been doing it for a long time, but he's very straight with you, and he's very genuine. So he'll tell you if there's something wrong. He'll not sell you a fish. He'll not just do it just to take the money off you. He's very friendly. But without no further ado, I would like to just get back to this. I collected these aquariums. He was throwing these two aquariums out. I asked him how much would he like for them, for me to take them off him, how much would he like, and he said to me that I could have them for free, just don't tell anyone. So yeah, and I'm not telling you guys, right? I know. So much for not saying a word, huh? So yes, so basically this is the bad tank. Now what I mean by bad tank is this one has the most damage to it, and this is the good one. Now the good one, right, did have an end to it, but during transportation, the end smashed. The end smashed. The tank slid in the back of the van. The tank slid and it just broke. So there's nothing I can do about that. The frustrating thing, and now it's actually quite funny looking back at it, on it, is that it happened at the very last bend. So I came round the last bend and I was literally 2 minutes away from my parents' home, and that's when it happened. I was driving and the next thing I just heard a smash. Now I thought that was very unfortunate, because it was a 20 minute to a 30 minute journey, and that happened 18 minutes into the journey. So I thought, I only have 2 more minutes to go, and that had to happen. Never mind. So the plans are now, I could get another piece of glass cut to size in order to replace the piece that broke, or I can take from here. Now for the time being, I am going to take it from here. So I'm going to take this piece here, and I'll clean this aquarium up really well. I have started to remove this, and the reason is that why. The reason is because he has it also here, or he had stuck it onto the bottom. But I don't want that. I want it to be clean. Also, I haven't decided yet whether to be able to look in from both sides of the aquarium or not. Originally, these were saltwater aquariums. Now, I know they're shallow for saltwater aquariums, but he had corals in these aquariums, so where he would just, you know, put the when he got his delivery in, he would put the corals in, and he basically sold them on from these tanks. So it worked out really well for him. But my intentions are to, after I've cleaned the tank up and I've repaired it, my intentions are to transform this into a freshwater aquarium. Simply because this is in my opinion, I feel like when it's a saltwater aquarium, marine fish, a marine aquarium, perhaps even a marine reef center, I like bigger aquariums. Now this is quite a shallow aquarium, and I like a big aquarium, especially for fish like that, where in diameter they can grow to a large size. So I'd like to ask you, what do you have in mind? Do you have any ideas, any thoughts, any suggestions that I could perhaps do with these aquariums? Or what freshwater fish should I go for? What do you think I should stock up these tanks with? Now, I also have another thing in mind, perhaps an aquascape, but why don't you tell me what you think I should do? Now, the 100 liter aquarium that I have shown you, that I am now using as a grow out tank, which my little brother kindly gave to me, is that should I do that, should I do an aquascape with that and keep this as a grow out tank, or should I do an aquascape in with this one and just keep that 100 liter aquarium as the grow out aquarium? So the reason why I can't make up my mind yet is because, well, first of all, I haven't even really began to work on it. All I've done is started to remove this. That's all. So anyway, please let me know what you guys think using the comment bar. And if you think none of it's a good idea, please let me know. Don't hesitate to share with me your thoughts. I am open to ideas and to opinions and whatnot, but please let me know if you can come up with any other ideas fish wise. I know my mother, this is where I actually have my parents' house, my mother, her favourite fish of all time are guppies and neon tetras. And she asked me for an aquarium that perhaps she could keep in her kitchen so long as she has those fish. So that is why I asked you, do you think I should give her the 100 liter aquarium make that an aquascape out of that aquarium and give her that? If so, what kind of aquascape do you think I should do? Now, I don't want to, for my mother, obviously she's got a family to attend to and to look after and provide for, to cook for and do the housework and everything. So I don't want for her to be tied down on an aquarium. I personally would do it for myself, because that's a passion of mine. But I feel like for her it's best that I do an eco-friendly aquarium and not a CO2 injected aquarium. And I know that you guys have probably been wondering, why have I never shown you my Reef Aquarium? Well, there is a very good reason for that, and I have, in 2011, this is a really nice story. In 2011, I met my wife. My wife at that time was living in London, and I've been based here in Glasgow. Meant that I would have to fly down or take a train down, even a coach, as I have done. But the thing is, I had to make a decision, and that decision meant I would have to make a huge sacrifice from my part. I thought, well, my wife being in London, I'm here in Glasgow, I really want to be able to see her as much as I possibly can, although I am also working at the same time. So what do I do? Because I can't be investing money into this amazing 100 liter aquarium, as well as traveling. So I thought, well, I could close the aquarium down and keep it, and in the future, whenever my wife and I get our own house, when we're able to buy a house, I do apologise, that was a truck passing by. I apologise for the noise, and already for the light is not great, the light in here, but yes, so I thought I could close it down, keep it, and when my wife and I are able to buy our own house, perhaps with a room large enough, if not, I could always do an extension specifically for this Reef Aquarium, and I could set it back up, and you know, basically what happened is I did a schoolboy error. I decided to leave the aquarium outside here in the garden, and basically it smashed. The worst thing I ever did was leave it outside, because it smashed. I have no regrets about closing the aquarium down so I can get down to London, because for me, you know, my wife makes me happy, so therefore I have no regrets, and I love my wife with everything I am and more, and I truly do appreciate her and cherish her, and I will do anything and everything for her. Now, don't get me wrong, I do miss having a marine aquarium, and I really miss sitting in front of that aquarium and just enjoying those amazingly beautiful fish with really striking and vibrant colours and whatnot. But I do believe that one day in the future I will have a marine aquarium. For the time being, I need to think about what I'm going to do with these ones or with this one, and meantime look after the 400 liter aquarium in the hotel that's about a bridge hotel, and in the restaurant there, that's where it is actually, the aquarium is actually inside there, the restaurant, which is really really nice. And I've heard lots of customers complimenting on it and saying that they love it, which is fantastic. I'm glad that they are able to enjoy it. The purpose of that being there is for customers to enjoy and to find and for it to be a nice relaxed atmosphere. Children just love going over to the aquarium and looking at the fish. So anyway, without me rambling on, just going off on one, I'd like to thank you all for watching. If you have enjoyed this video, please, you know, hit that like button, you know, that thumbs up. And if you thought this video was poor or poor quality, or you never liked it, thought it was rubbish, you know, then feel free to, you know, hit that dislike button, you know, thumbs down, you know, all the way down. It doesn't matter, you know. The point that matters here is that we have been able to communicate, to interact about aquariums, because you know we're all on the same boat here. You know, we're both are lovers and passionate about fish and fish keeping, and you know, looking after aquariums. It really is our passion. So please, you know, comment, and please do give me ideas. So, thank you all for watching, and I hope you have a great week, and everything continues going well with your aquariums. Thanks again, and peace out.